Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Rick's Gadgets. Today I want to talk about Zwave and kind of Zigbee networks and the mesh network architecture that they're built off of and how it can affect your performance on your home automation system. So stick around. Hey everyone, welcome back. So today I want to talk about the Zwave Zigbee mesh network architecture. The other day I was adding a device to my system, and what happened was I added it to the system, but when I put it in its final location, I realized that the signal wasn't quite getting the reception that I thought I should get. Then I realized that what happened was I had configured it in one part of the house, moved it to another. So what I want to do today is kind of give you an overview of how those networks are configured and how they rely on one device to communicate with another device. So here on this diagram, when you add a device to the system, like here, I'm going to add it to my HomeSeer system, you will configure it to your main hub. And what that hub is, that's your starting point. And as you add devices, each device acts as a repeater. So the more devices you get on your network, the better range you can get. Because as you can see, you can start out with one or two devices close to your central hub. Then as you start expanding those out, those start talking to the neighbors, and then those allow even further connections to those neighbors, and you can see how adding devices will increase the coverage of your home. And this will allow you to put devices outside of the house and have control. For example, I have one in my garage that will basically talk to the one out near my mailbox. I have one in my office that talks to the pond pump in the backyard. And those are about 15 to 20 feet away from the house, and I have no issues with them. And that's because of the mesh network. Now, Zwave and Zigbee, they kind of work on this principle, and that's the two common ones that you see in, you know, HomeSeer for Zwave, Zigbee and Zwave and the Smarthings from Samsung. You also see it in the Lowe's Iris devices as well. And what you want to do is kind of pay attention as to how it's set up, because if you move the devices around when it was allocated to the system, it may have a certain neighbor that it's looking for, and if you move it across the other end of the house, it may still be looking for that original neighbor that was close by, which is now further away. So there's a couple things you can do, and Smarthings, I think you can go in and do a repair, and it will go out and wake up all the devices and I think get them to reconfigure themselves and get the best path from the hub out to the device. And within HomeSeer, it's in the Zwave Manage controller management. And in here, all you want to do is, it's called Optimize, fully optimize the network. And once you start this, it will go out and start looking at the nodes and figure out which ones are next to each other and which ones have the best range for each one down the line. So that's just two ways. So if you start noticing you're having a little bit of issues with some of your devices and they're not picking up like they should, maybe you need to run a repair and see if that will fix your problem. So anyway, I hope this information here is useful, and I appreciate you stopping by today. And if you have any questions, drop them in the comments section below, and I would appreciate it if you would subscribe to my channel and hit the thumbs up if you think this was worth it. And y'all have a great day. Thank you.